Welcome to Crazy Shit in Real Estate, a weekly podcast where I walk you through some of the wildest, most unbelievable stories you'll hear from the world of real estate. If you like real estate and you love crazy, this is a podcast for you.
And welcome back to the podcast. I'm Leigh Brown, and you're listening to Crazy Shit in Real Estate. And today's guest, if you're really thinking and paying attention to all the little episodes, you might recognize that his wife has already appeared on the show, and we totally called him out to make him show up. This is Todd Ferris. Todd, say hey to everybody.
Hello, everybody. How are you?
Oh, they can't talk back to us, can they? They can't talk back to you, but you can imagine it with the voices in your head. So why don't you tell them who you're married to and what market y'all are in and all that fun little stuff, how long you've been in real estate, the usual.
I am married to Patrick Lilly, and I am married to Megan.
He's available. Let's find him a good, sweet man.
He's awesome. I love that guy. I am married to the fabulous and beautiful Megan Ferris, and she's the better half, much, much better. And so she, I believe, told you some good stuff, but I'm going to come with even better stuff.
Oh, I did not know there was an internal Ferris family competition. This is awesome. So the Ferris kids will come on next and we can get the squirrel story, which is still like my favorite ever.
That's right. No, there's always a competition between what we do.
Okay. So the ground rules of the podcast are pretty simple. No F-bombs or GDs because I'm allergic to those words. And if there's a guilty party, don't name them so that only they can identify themselves. And with that being said, do tell what crazy mess you have seen in this business.
All right. So I believe my wife did a top five list, and in true competitive form, I'm going to do a top three list just to two up her. But I've got three and they're exciting. They involve guns and drugs and potential kidnapping situations. Really not that extreme, but we're going to go with it. So I'm going to start it off with number three story, which is my wife and I, Megan and I, we were looking at investment properties, and so we went to check out this one property, show up and make all the noise that we typically do, wiggle the handle, and then we take the key and we pop it in, and I open the door, and I usually am the first one to go in, and as soon as I open the door, I see a guy jump off the couch and reach for a gun on the table, and so immediately Megan and I went running the other way, and turns out that he was a tenant of the home, and the landlord forgot to tell him about the showing, and he was a security guard sleeping off the night shift and was not expecting us, but always had his gun by his side because it was not a nice neighborhood.
Yeah, I mean, people don't like realtors. We don't rank very high in the list of professions that are beloved, and I guess this guy took it to a whole nother level.
He did. Yeah, it was a little nerve wracking at the time, but we ended up having a good conversation with him. He chose not to shoot us, which is always good. And then we did not buy the home though, because we figured that he may be involved moving forward as a tenant, and that made us nervous.
That's bad juju, man. You buy the next house.
That's right. So that was my number three story. My number two story is more on a national level, and this was my early in my career. I was working with a renter, as I often did back then, and so I was working with this family, and we're showing them all around town, and they were looking for rental homes and pretty nice value rental homes. So I was looking at a whopping $200 that was going to come back to me, so I was pretty excited about it, and everything worked out. We found him a rental home, and his family was excited about it. All was good. I helped them sign the lease and all that fun stuff. And then about 2 months later, I get a phone call from the landlord, and he's saying, "Hey, what did you just do? Who did you put in my house?" And I was, you know, I have no idea what you're talking about. So he says, "Turn on the news. Just go ahead and turn on any channel." And so I flip on the news, and apparently there was this nation, you know, I think it was actually international, drug cartel ring was exposed, and the FBI and all, or whoever does all the drug bust, came knocking down their door. And it was my tenant and his family, and he was involved in this major drug cartel. And so then all of a sudden I started thinking back to how many times I saw like a flower shop van outside a home, or whether or not they've been running any of my information through the ringers to see if I was somebody that was involved as well. Made me a little nervous, but in true service to the client, the wife did call me later and ask me to come over and help figure out what to do with their lease moving forward. So, and I still, even though they were a part of a big national drug cartel, I went over there and I performed admirably for my clients.
Well, you know, they were on every news station. So if you hadn't, you might have wound up on every news station. So it's a good reason to maintain the professionalism that you were looking at. I think that was a big giveaway. And they're like, look, turn on any news channel.
That's a bad sign. Right. I was hoping that, you know, just like you get 10% of the rent or the first month's rent, I figured maybe 10% of the drugs I could turn around and sell it. And no, that we don't do that. That's bad, people.
That's in different parts of the country, not in Indianapolis, right? Not your little wholesome Midwest people.
That's right. No, we are nice people. We sometimes will say bad words, but nothing like the F-bomb, Leigh. We keep it clean.
See, that's right, because you're wholesome like that. Right, Megan? Right. See, she can't respond, but I know she's listening.
That's right. She's always listening.
Okay, so drum roll for number one.
All right, so this one's just kind of fun for me because it was so early. This was actually the second home I ever showed, and we had faked out, well, hopefully, I doubt anybody's listening because this was 10 years ago. No, I'm sure a lot of people are listening, but not these people. But so I wanted to get a feel for how the whole showing process works. So I actually set up showings to go out and look at homes with my wife and her mom as my fake clients. And so I went and previewed the first home just so I really knew what I was doing, but I didn't bother with the second. And so we went out. First home went well, was in and out. You know, I was just getting a feel for how the whole showing process works. Show up at the second home, and I didn't know this, but apparently sellers every once in a while will stay at the home. Well, we show up and we knock on the door, and unbeknownst to me, there's somebody there, and they let us in. Well, it's a gentleman with longer hair, and he's in his probably early 50s, and he's standing in his bathrobe as well as holding a small dog, and I have no idea what brand or breed this dog was, but he's just stroking this dog slowly and says in kind of a menacing voice, "Feel free to come in." And so I look at my wife and I look at her mom and said, "Well, okay, I guess this is how it works in this business." So we went inside the home and we walked around, and sure enough, he would just follow us slowly, stroking this dog and watching every step and move we made. And all I could envision from that point forward was that scene from,
Silence
the movie?
Silence of the Lambs.
Yes.
Yes. The lips in the basket. Are you kidding me? You went in the house?
We went in. I was providing excellent service to my clients, and I assumed that was what it was going to be.
Keep your clients alive, brother. Get them out the house. Oh, Lord, I'm creeping out just listening to the front half of that.
It still freaks me out. But yeah, that's all I see. And that's all I picture is just that guy. It puts the lotion on its skin.
Ah, and the night vision goggles, all that mess. Do you remember that?
Oh, yeah. That's a good one.
So wait a minute, they buy the house?
Well, no, because it was all fake anyways. We were just doing it for my experience. So the poor sellers, well, not that poor seller. He was probably glad there was just, if it would have been less than a, we would have been in a well somewhere at some point.
Dang, that's, yeah, they don't teach you that in pre-licensing class.
No, there's a lot that they omit, and that's one of them.
I don't think any of those million-dollar agents on Bravo have ever had an experience like that.
No, I think they're putting lotion on their skin, but it's while they're riding their yacht down the Manhattan River.
Well, after you've had all that work done, you got to keep the scars looking good so nobody knows. Oh, geez.
So that's what those are my top three. I mean, I've got a bunch of little ones, but we've all heard of, people having sex and doing things in homes that they shouldn't be doing, but those aren't as much fun. So that's what I got for you. Hopefully it topped my wife.
Well, we'll have to let the listeners vote. They can, you know, like review the podcast and leave it in their remarks, and then we'll tweet it back out and we'll see who gets some good tweet action, if it's Megan Ferris or Todd Ferris. But either way, if they want to reach the Ferris Realty Property Group, or whichever the name of your group is, in their Indianapolis area, how can people find y'all for professional awesome service?
Well, if you want professional awesome service, we're going to direct you to some of the other agents in our area. But for just decent service with a smile, you can go to ferrispropertygroup.com or hit us up on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all that fun stuff. And then personally, you can reach me at todd@ferrispropertygroup.com. And that's F-E-R-R-I-S, just like a Ferris wheel.
And I will include all of Todd's information in the show notes for this episode if you're driving or struggling on the elliptical while you're listening. So look it up for more information. Contact them for anything related to Indianapolis real estate. Thank you for coming on the show, and I can't wait to see who wins the great viewer support. Well, viewers, I don't know, listener support between the husband and wife battle here.
And oh, it's on. Vote for me, people.
Always, right? The kids will vote for mom, though, so you know you're out there, but it's all good. But, you know, if you're a realtor, inspector, investor, lender, or a consumer who's got your own crazy story about real estate, I mean, sometimes your spouse is the crazy one in real estate, so give me a shout. Let me know. We'll feature you on the show. Subscribe for more episodes, and always remember that the best realtors can survive even the crazy shit in real estate, and we will see you all next time. Thanks, Todd.
Hey, thank you, Leigh.
For joining us this week on the Crazy Shit in Real Estate podcast. If you liked what you heard, please visit crazyshitinrealestate.com, where you can access the full show notes for this episode, additional content produced exclusively for listeners, and much, much more.